Hello and welcome to another wonderful day. Today we're going to be looking at how to feed in some data into our database. And for us to do this, let's get to share our screen and start immediately. Okay. So the instructions we are taking, all of them are on our website, www.jambwaeknekoyuni.com/django-steps. So if you go through it, you're going to see this is where we're going to continue for today. Then if you also get to the Django Project website, you also see the same thing that we're supposed to do. So all of them are here, and that is what we're going to be doing. And to do that, I'm going to quickly get to my VS Code. You can see that I'm already in the Fold Django, which is the official folder that we're using for this work. We're inside the poster. So this the directly you can read from here. It's inside Fold Django. So I'm going to quickly seed into poster. That's the first thing I'm doing. So make sure that you're inside the poster. So I'm there and I'm going to run the server. And to run the server, we already know how to run the server. We use Python manage.py run server. Python manage.py space run server. So that is how you run the server. So we want to run the server to make sure that everything is up. Because once everything is up, that's when we can start affecting the changes and everything will work perfectly. So I hope you are following up, and anytime you miss any lecture, all our lectures are on our website, on our YouTube Live and Facebook Live. YouTube Live is on tclassified.com. Facebook Live is on my timeline, Augustine Ekenemeka. You can always follow us up there and get all this. Then very, very importantly, we have a new YouTube channel that we just hosted. The name is Austin Kenner. It's gonna be having our subsequent lectures on machine learning. We'll be on that new YouTube channel. We are starting our machine learning today. Time is 2 to 3. Machine learning, very delicate machine learning classes. It's gonna be very rich. We are starting it from today, 2 to 3 every day. So the edited video and everything about that and every other thing that we'll be doing will be on the new channel, Austin Kenner channel. You can check it out. I'll drop the link on the edited version of this video so that you can check it out. So you can see that the server is running now. So I'm gonna copy this address where the server is running. Some of you that are doing control click and it's not working, just simply copy this, get to a new tab and paste it there. Press the enter key to run. Yeah, you want to do it. And bring change of institution, sit down there a little. Okay, so I'm gonna do /post. Okay, so this is where we stopped. Hello, Django developers, you are the post index. That was the last thing we did. And having done that, we're gonna follow up with what we have for today, which I told you is we're gonna using Shell to manage the database. So to do that, this is the code I'm picking. This code, like I said, is on jambwaeknekoyuni.com/django-steps. So it simply say Python manage.py shell. It's a very simple code. So I'm gonna put it up here. I'm gonna open another terminal for me to do this. So this is another terminal I'm opening, but make sure when you're in that terminal, make sure you see it into poster. Very, very important, poster. Okay, I'm in poster. So I'm gonna simply say Python space manage.py shell, because I want to open up the shell so that I can input some data in the database. So that I can see the way it looks. So that's why we're going to Python manage.py shells. Okay, so once shells come out, this is the way it comes out in. In shell, you can write code, Python code, just normally the way you do on your editor. So I'm gonna, first of all, I'm gonna write from pools.models import choice and question. Choice and question are the models that were earlier created. So if you also open Django projects, this is the same code, from pools, import choice and question. These are the two models, the two tables in our database. So we want to import them and be able to do other things. So from pull.django, you can simply pick out this code if you're on this website to make it easier for you. So that's the first thing. So I'm gonna just put it here. So from pull.model, that's the model that is inside the pulls app. Please import for me choice and question. So those are the two things I've imported. And if you're checking through these, you're gonna see some instructions on this. It's simply saying that we're importing the model classes we just wrote. And you remember in the last class, we wrote these models. So no questions in the system yet. So if you do question.object.all, you're not gonna see any question because there are no questions yet. But that is what we're gonna be putting today. We're gonna be putting some questions there. So let's say I run this code, question.object.all. As a function, you can see empty query set, nothing is there yet. So we're gonna try putting in some things. So now, the next thing we're gonna be doing is, No, make sure you've done the needs. Make sure you wrote the choice and question exactly the way they are. Okay, make sure you wrote it exactly the way they are. Yes, any other question? Okay. Oh, maybe you've not followed the procedure. Any other question? Okay. So if you read through, you're gonna see where you wrote, create a new question, that's what we're trying to do now. Then support for time zone is enabled in default setting. Django expect date time, okay? So we're gonna try to create question. And to do that, we're gonna import this time zone so that it can pick out the right time that we are creating the question. So that's why we are importing this. So simply run this import from Django util import time zone, because we want to take note of the times that we are using to create these various questions. Okay. So I'm gonna get back immediately and create the first question. And the question, first question says, what is new? That is the question text. So I'm gonna come here, Control V. So you can see the question is equal to what? The question text is what is new. And I'm creating it at a particular time, and that time is taken care of by simply saying time zone dot now. That's why we imported this time zone. Okay. So having created the question, I have to save it, because it is only when I save it that it will now become in our database. I'm gonna do Control C. So Q is the variable name that we gave in order to create this question. So we're gonna do Q.save in order to save. Okay, Control C. So I'm gonna pick this Q.save. Okay, so that question is created and saved. So the next thing I'm gonna do, now it has an ID and it also has, Python automatically adds ID for you. If you want to see whether it really has an ID, just do q.id to see the ID of this first question. Because this is the first question, it's gonna have an ID of one. You can see the ID there. So it's having the ID of one. You can also check out what the question text is because you've created it. So how do you check it out? By simply saying q.questionText. It's as simple as that. q.questionText. Okay, you can see what is new. That is the text of the question. So move forward. Want to create another question, but we can also ask about the date that we use for this question. So I'm gonna simply pick this out. So you can see the date, it's clearly written there. So let's create another question, which is what's up? That's the next question we want to create. queue dot question text, then you apply. So that question is created now. So the next one will be to save. Take note, whenever you create, you must save. Whenever you create, you must save the question. If you don't save the question, it is not fully created. So that is saved now. So after creating, I can now access for all the questions created or everything inside by simply saying question.object.all. And that is the code I'm gonna run next. Okay. So wait a minute and okay. So that is what we'll have. Inside our pulse.model, we are supposed to define the strings. That's what we are gonna do next. So inside your pulse.model, open your pulse.model. That means the model inside the pulse app. So if you get to your app, this is my pulse app. So when I open it, I'll see models. So these are the models I've created. So I'm gonna convert this to a string so that it can communicate with other data in the shell and everything. So that's what we're gonna try to do now. So and to do that, you simply define a function, str, then let it take an argument of solve. So do that for question and do that for models. That's what we're gonna do. So I simply say Control C to pick this out. Then I get back here. So for question, I'm gonna do it. Control V. Then I'm also gonna do it for choice. Okay, so I'm gonna right click to save. So it's important to add up this string function method to your model, not only for your own convenience when dealing with interactive prompts, but also because object representations are used throughout Django automatically generated admin. So let's also add a custom method to this model. So we can also add another custom method to this model before we continue creating other questions and answers. So I'm gonna leave us more time to meet up with what I've just done so far, so that once you are done, you can continue. So please try to follow up. Make sure that you run your server, do your run server, very, very important. And make sure you do it in the right directory. Immediately after doing that, get to impute the codes that we've done so far, so that when you're done, we can continue.